So what is she like, this girl you see?
She's the most beautiful thing I've ever seen. Brown hair. Deep eyes. She's perfect.
And how long have you been seeing her?
Over 2 months ago. She was walking towards me. She was even calling my name. I was looking for her, but I can't find her, and now I can find her everywhere. She's been stalking me. Make her stop!
Well, since you've never been in a physical contact before, don't you think it might be an illusion?
You think I'm crazy, don't you?
Do you believe in superstitions?
I never did. But ever since I saw her, she's been leading me to those things. And all I know is my life has been ruined because of them.
Sometimes these situations occur because you want them to. You are really deep down inside, you are superstitious. And this girl is the image of perfection for you. This girl might not be real, but
she's fucking real. I see her.
Here, come to me.
Leave me, superstition.
Make her stop!
She's real.
She's real!
You believe in superstition?
Come to me.
I see her. I want her to go away.
Leave me alone! Leave me alone!
Montagia. It's a disease.
You could say that a person with melomontagia has a very isolated life.
It is a somewhat psychological. Basically, it has to do with remembering things from your past at very inconvenient moments of the day.
The correlation to what I'm actually talking about usually isn't there.
I don't really go out very much.
Just the overwhelming feeling of emotion.
Bottling up a lot of my real feelings. A lot of anger.
Rage and fear and sadness are all present in the montage, but the actual moments, details of the story are kind of lost in the melodrama of it all.
This is when the wife probably happened.
She left me.
Oh, God.
My disease is absolutely not superstition. It's very real.
No, this is an actual disease. You know, I mean, is Crohn's disease superstitious? You know, Hodgkin's, Lou Gehrig's disease, any of those. You know what I mean? Like, those aren't superstitious.
Like, are you real?
Do you think I'm real? Come to me.
Crazy. They locked me in here because I see you. Show yourself. show yourself to them. Let them know you're real.
No.
I hear you doing this! Stop!
I'm not doing anything. You only choose to do this to yourself when you started believing in me. Even though you know I'm not real and that you can't touch me and that I do not exist. You don't want to let go. You want to keep thinking I'm real.
I want to know why you're doing this. Why are you here in my life?
You want to know why I'm here? Come with me. I'm just a little bit crazy, and nothing can help. I'm not even worth saving. Just want to freak out and ball my fists. Just break these walls. Don't know.
In Omar's case, obsession is what drove him. His mind created an image which only he can see or contact. It's possibly a symbol of his beliefs or fear, which was in a form of a girl leading him to superstitious thoughts which he was following blindly. Montage patients are usually unaware of their case, which puts them in a state of denial. Omar Gaafar escaped before we finished our analysis. Some say it was suicide, and some others say he was murdered. His case is just under investigation. This was the final analysis on case 1313, Omar Gaafar, on June 6, 06.